for all the assistance you've been helping us out with developing the product.
It's been a lot of fun, actually.
What's the latest on your projects?
Still doing a lot of session work and a lot of stuff sent to me. Never quite know one day from the next what you're going to play. And we're working on Billy Dorsey's new album when it comes out. First on the single and then on the album. He's busy doing other things, so I'm going to get that nailed down. I may even talk to him while I'm here and work on that some more. Yeah, just working well with that.
Excellent.
I'm going to stay busy.
Excellent. So tell me about the guitar you're playing.
This is actually one of the Sur Pro series, but I custom ordered the pickups. It's got V60 LPs as the single coils and the Sur humbucker here. I'm rather than two tone controls, I give it a single delay, but a single tone is always in my delay. Yeah, Sur guitars are absolutely amazing.
Yeah,
I feel.
Well, I know this is your personal one. I actually contacted John, I was going to send one out, but I know it's something about having your own personal one with you, so thanks for traveling extra mile.
All the way from Hawaii.
Exactly.
Hawaii guitar.
Exactly. So I want to tell our viewers, because the wireless system didn't happen overnight. We spent a lot of time going back and forth with Ron and other artists and other users getting their feedback. But they would talk about it from your point of view. What was that like?
I enjoyed the first systems that came out. I had slight issues with latency because of how I hear things, because I was super picky about the response and it being immediate. We talked about that, went back and forth. I got it improved or not. I was very, very happy with it. We seem to have taken care of that issue. And actually, the newest update now, the ones that I'm playing today, are EQ'd better for my ear. It's just it's the best wireless unit I've used, definitely. And I'm getting in a place where I'm playing out more and doing more outside of the studio work. So I'm needing to get further away from my amps and further away from things. The wireless system's definitely coming in handy. And this is the best my ears have heard, definitely.
Thanks. And we're going to enlist you to help us out with the overdrive pedals, too.
Yeah.
We're showing two new overdrive pedals at the show, and they're prototypes. But the reason they're prototypes is because we want to get feedback of our artists and the other users. And these are familiar overdrives in circuits, but they have variac features. And what's your feel so far? I know you have your favorite, so.
I do. And it's not the favorite that I thought it would be.
Right.
The slightly mid-bumped one here has become my favorite.
Okay.
I like the variac control because I like being able to adjust it for whatever room I'm in and adjust the sag and the tightness of the bottom end depending on the sound that I'm hearing. Because no two rooms are the same, no two days are the same. Your ears change from day to day. I can set up my guitar in the morning and come back at night and it sounds totally different than the way I left it. And even digital gear can sound different because the heat has changed, the guitar has changed. So being able to adjust that variac function and get the tightness of the low end exactly where I want it on the fly is very interesting to me.
It's interesting you mentioned the room, the sound of the room, and you're the first person that really talks about different sound, adjusting for the sound of the room, but with your background in studios and doing production work, I guess that's a completely different point of view, not just from a guitar point, but also from a production point. It's really interesting.
It is, but I'm talking more actually about live room.
Okay.
Because the reflection of a live room is so different than you'll be playing a short stage with people up close to you one day, you play a large stage with people far away, and the sound that your ear hears varies from moment to moment and from room to room. So one amp that sounds great in one room won't sound great in another. It's not even wattage, it's just sometimes the bottom end is there, sometimes there's too much treble in the room. So we've always been able to EQ things on a pedal to get our tone the way we want. Being able to adjust what I consider to be the sag in the bottom end and the tightness from a room to room situation is very interesting to me. Yeah, something I'm looking at.
Cool. Well, thank you so much for coming.
Sure. All right. Thanks for having me.
All right. Take it away.
It's been fun to be here. Yeah. It's been a lot of fun.